I think the key there as a startup and as one that's growing is you want your engineers and product teams to be focused on building product. So you really have to take on the responsibility yourself as a sales engineering team. It'd be great, right, if we could take the folks who are responsible for our email template, or sorry, our email pipeline or even email templates out and say, hey, can you build, you know, a special custom email template for this big customer? But as a company that's growing at scale, that's completely impossible to do. And it doesn't make sense, right? And you're hurting your growth by doing that. So I think the key to a sales engineering company doing, a sales engineering department doing this, is you have to be autonomous. You have to be able to do this yourself. So we had our own AWS environment that we, you know, we're working with our security team and making sure that we do everything above board. You don't want to just go rogue on stuff like this. But what you want to be able to do is be completely autonomous, be able to manage and be responsible for this yourself. And then instead of, you know, having story points that you have to give people, which are never going to get approved, right? You're going to have engineers that are focused on their tasks. You're not going to be able, and you would never want to overcommit them or supersede their own responsibilities. So what you have to do is be able to be really creative, really resourceful. And then those same engineers will be more than willing to help you. You know, maybe after 5 o'clock, if you meet them in the kitchen, you know, you share a beverage with them or you catch them for lunch sometime. People are more than willing to help you on, you know, one-offs here and there. But you really have to be autonomous and be able to do the work yourself is what we found.